Hello and welcome everybody, Ragnarok here with part number 5 of my Kong Rong Three Kingdoms Let's Play on a Legendary difficulty. We are trying to work our way out of the hole that we find ourselves in. We've got a little ways to go yet. Wang Shao is our main enemy now. We've defeated the army that spawned here, thankfully, and reuniting our other provinces. We've got to be a little bit wary of potentially getting attacked here, but I think our next move is to hit Dongping. Another thing, this settlement, I went back, I looked at the tape, and it was not part of the peace negotiations, and it as soon as we signed the peace negotiations, it switched over to Gongsuzan as soon as we did that. So I'm not sure if that was some kind of bug in the game, or if there was something that I'm missing, but just really bizarre. And you know, the really unfortunate thing is too, is that this settlement was essentially paying for this secondary army of ours, which we really need right now. And as you can see, our cash flow minus 350, but I'm thinking if we can take this, that potentially that will get us back to even. Kind of hoping. We're gonna build the inn here, and over here we've got to demolish these buildings. Downgrade or demolish? Downgrade, refund 150. Just demolish these buildings. Actually, maybe downgrade this first, because we can only build one at a time and we'll get a little bit of extra cash doing it that way, downgrading it and then demolishing it the next time. But yeah, I really want to keep this army because we kind of need those extra troops. Bollocks. We're not in any kind of shape to move against the enemy at the moment. This guy enables fire arrows plus 8 cunning, plus cunning. You know what? It wouldn't be the worst thing in the world for him to have some archers. Let's go fire arrows for him. I was thinking about disbanding this guy and recruiting some archers for this guy. But I guess that would be a little bit wasteful. Yeah, bollocks. I don't know. I want to keep this guy, but how much is he costing us total? How much is the retinue is costing us? 280. 280, that's not much. Put your enemy in camp stance. How many turns? 6 turns till they're fully replenished. Ah, shoot. I always forget to apply it. I guess that's a good thing. A little failsafe in there in case you guys are actually in not too bad of attitude right now. We moved in. How many turns did I say? 5 turns. Turns. 5 turns. We move over to here. Let our archers do all of the work. But if we run into Huang Shao's army over here, that's the thing I'm worried about. I wish this game had agents, like proper classic Total War agents. It's the one thing about the game that really puts me off. Like, the rest of the game I love. There's a lot of depth in the campaign. Friendship forming. A lot of depth in the campaign. You know, the battles are great because you've got the largest armies out of any Total War. There's just a lot of really great things about it. And I mean, I'm talking about records mode. I hate playing the game on romance mode where you have the single entity generals. I don't think the game... I think that was the influence Warhammer had on the game, but records mode is excellent. But yeah, just so many good things about the game. I just wish that there were actual proper agents in the game. But anyway, friendship forming. When battle is done, it is heartening to know that there are friends awaiting us to laugh and tease and make the battle a distant memory. Such a bond is formed between two of your soldiers, and it is heartening to see this companionship enduring and growing over time. Zen Yang, friendship deepens between Zen Yang and Shi Yi. All right, that's good, that's good, that's good. All right, yeah. Yeah, well, we just signed peace with him, so we can't attack him. What I'm kind of hoping here is that we can defeat Huang Shao. We're nice and protected here with Liu Bei. How is it that we can't get freaking trade with Liu Bei? Liu Bei negotiate. Oh, maybe it's because maybe he doesn't have a trade agreement. Maybe it's because he doesn't have a trade agreement available. Maybe that's why. But yeah, a trade agreement would come in real handy.
We
could trade with him. Both factions must have a free trade route and also share a border between your territory and theirs. Yeah, so trade is not an option. It would really help things out right now. Alright, so this we're gonna demolish. And we got a little bit more cash coming in. That'll give us a little bit more cash. So we should be okay. Let's build... we can't afford it. I'm gonna say let's build an inn here too. Shoot. Yeah, being in the negative and bleeding money. Now, how much, 14%. If we, move you out of the settlement, down to 12%. It's only 2%. And we can potentially see how... Trying to see here. Can we... I think we can reach there on the next turn. So let's park right here by the border. Alright, so... It's not Huang Shao. But it is a pretty big army. That's not good. That's not good at all. You park there. Though if they attack us, we should be able to withdraw and withdraw out of their range and we'll still be within our own territory. Yeah, we need to fully replenish. We should be able to take this on. That's a lot of infantry. A lot of infantry. And it doesn't look like they have much cavalry, but because they've got these horse archers. They've got a couple horse archers there. It's a dangerous, or actually a dangerous looking army. Huang Shao has an army as well, if I'm not mistaken. Which is pretty crazy, considering the situation we're in. Bollocks. How much is this demolishing for? Refund 300. We won't even be able to... God dang it. Can't even afford to build here. I think, much as I don't want to... Oh man, I don't know what to do right now. Because we can't afford to build. Doesn't look like Oh man. This is not a pleasant situation to be in here right now. And we can't get. Alright, what do we got for choices here? So, income from commerce. Let's actually issue that. Did not do anything. We were not making anything from commerce. So this will be commerce. So that'll make us a little bit of money. So we'll be making a little bit of profit. I don't think that we can afford to get rid of that army with such a big army on our border. Ooh, I wonder what's over here. But a level five, and Dongping's got a decent garrison as well. Thing is, Huangshao is at war with a lot of factions as well, so that could potentially be undefended. But if they come down here for Kongrong, that could be trouble. I wonder, Liu Bei, let's negotiate with Liu Bei. What could we trade him? He's got plenty of food. We've only got a little bit of food anyway. We could trade him an ancillary. Holy shit. Holy shit. Hang on one second. When did I get those weapons? Let's take a look here. I guess we stole that. Let's just stole some. Look at this. Plus 9 instinct. Plus 10 charge bonus. Let's give you that. Equip you with that. Already got it. Plus 6 authority. Do we have any, alright. Armor, no. Alright. Yeah, just double check his armor. Over here. Okay, armor's good. Let's see. Oh, look at this. Oh, sick. Plus 15 resolve. That'll, yes, I like it. I like it. Very nice. And Kongrong. I think Kong's already got. I think they usually these guys start with some pretty good weapons. So that means we could sell this heirloom spear to let's see if we can sell some other stuff to him instead, because I wouldn't mind holding on to that trade. So one of the nice things, that's the only accessories. Look at that, flying daggers. Those are pretty sick. Wow. All right. That was totally not worth it. alright, let's try, god dang, I don't. What do we got? 3.3, what can we get, isn't it? Why won't? What am I doing wrong here? I don't want to make a payment. Why, alright, there we go. How much can we get? Alright, now we're talking. Kind of sucks to lose such a great item. But we're in a really desperate situation right now, financially speaking. And this could, financially speaking and militarily speaking. Alright, there we go. 1100. Let's do it. But our generals, we did have some other weapons that our generals had that were pretty awesome, so kind of works out okay. So Bahai, let's build. First thing we want to build is the inn, and then we'll build a land surveying office. But yeah, let's get the inn built there. And so with the two inns built, 600. Oh, we're still not going to be able to afford to build the grant. If we can get a fight, we can get some money from that. We've got him addicted to our gear. I guess we could trade those flying daggers. That will give us a little bit more money too. The daggers are probably worth something. Yeah, I had a feeling they were going to come and attack us. But I think we should definitely retreat here. Deployed 800. Oh, they're attacking this guy. But yeah, I think we should replenish a little bit before we take that guy on. I march back to his own territory. Whoo, looters. So we're down to minus 200. Yeah, losing this province really, really kicked me in the you know what. Let's see here. Oh yeah. It's worth quite a bit to him. Yeah, it's an awesome ancillary again, and one that we could actually apply right now. But so like I was saying before, just the situation is a little bit desperate. Oh, I might be able to get a little bit more. There we go. Alright, 1100, does that give us enough to build over here? Oh, we can't build because we're constructing that. Alright. Alright. What's your movement? We gotta fall back this way with Kong. Stay away from that army. And we can't go into Force March because we won't get replenishment in Force March. Kind of wanted to move him up to here. I'd like to see what's going on over here, but then that puts him at risk. This guy might come over here and attack this. Let's just stay, keep the army together. Because we lose the army, we're dead. We're in a really precarious position right now, just because of the finances. Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I could have. What we could have done, we could have left the two buildings that were here, that weren't our type. I think we were still getting money from them, but it's just better to have it our own building so that we can reinvest in them. God dang, what a. But yeah, this army, I'm sure we can take this arm. Well, whoops. I feel confident that we should be able to take this army once we're fully replenished, I think. Big army. Liu Bei came over here and helped us out a little bit. Huang Shao, I can't afford that. Are you crazy? We're freaking flat-ass broke right now. I wouldn't mind getting non-aggression with him. Hopefully he doesn't follow the same track that Gongsun Zan did. He offered us a similar deal for non-aggression, and then the next turn declared war on us. Guys... I don't want to fight them in the woods there either. Maybe we try and set up an ambush here by our settlement, because we'll get a little bit of reinforcements. Or no, let's park over here. Park on this side. Ah, shit. Too much movement. It's gonna go into encampment stance. Ambush. See if that spurs them to attack. And then land development is what we want to build. And look at that. We're in the green. We're in the green. So long as we don't lose any more territory, which is a risk right now because we can't protect all of it. Good news. Good news. Huang Shao was defeated by Yuang Shao there. So though we don't have non-aggression with this guy, I wonder if minus 3.2. Yeah, I don't think we got enough to offer him. One. Well, we'll just have to Yuan Shao is one of the most difficult to battle in this, because he's got some bonuses to replenishment. As you can see, it's taking us forever to replenish right now. He replenishes, like, he's got some one of his faction traits or whatever is increase in replenishment, which makes him exceedingly difficult to get rid of. But I think we'll be going to war with Gongsun Zan and heading north when the time comes. But yeah, I'd like to capture this. Let's see if this army makes the attack there. Oh. Alright. Liu Bei is going to do our job for us, but can we get to Dongping before he does? Good to have friends. Good to have friends. So our whole southern and western flank are kind of protected if we can...
Oh.
Alright, how much movement you got, bud? Ah, shit. I think he does have enough movement to attack it. Move to the border there. Alright, just a small army. All right, Liu Bei just... maybe he doesn't. Maybe he doesn't have enough movement to get there. I don't know. If he does, it's just barely, but it's just a small army. A small garrison. I mean, that's a decent garrison. Seven will still be, you know... Oh, we're minus 33 now. Alright, this should give us... I guess the different seasons affect it. Yeah, I do the one... Oh, no, no, no! Fuck. I really wanted that settlement. Really wanted that settlement. I wasn't expecting him to battle that army there. I mean, how often do you get bailed out by the AI? Faction destroyed Huang Shao. We are all right. Diplomacy. It's rich. Yeah, I'm just wondering how many turns. I guess we can declare. I guess it's been 10 turns since he declared peace on us. We're still not fully replenished. But yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna declare war on him. I'm gonna hope that Huang Shao doesn't declare war on us. Who's he? So he's at war with Rizong, Han Empire, Dongzhou, and Gongs. Oh, he's at war with Gongtun Zan as well. Can you? Damn, I was hoping that we could offer to join the war against Gongsun Zan and see what he says to that, but doesn't look like you're able to do that. But yeah, we're pretty much back to full strength. Yeah, so we can hit this, and then we can cross there. We really desperately need to get these settlements built up, but expanding will help us gain a little bit of cash. And I do want to get that non-aggression with Yuan Shao, if we can. This is that right there is a deadly army. These dudes are tough to deal with. A little bit of cash. I mean, it's sort of like a mixed bag. They've got a lot of stuff in there. We prefer shielded units to those, but anyway. But just, you know what, the fact that it's a full stack is a big deal. Because this game, records mode, is a numbers game. Whoever's got the numbers usually comes out on top. All right. You gotta be shitting me. The alliance of alliance of the alliance of alliance of the Locust Tree has declared war on you. All right, well, Yuan Shao or Gongtun Zan is gonna have to wait. Because that's going to man. Game. this campaign has not gotten off to a good start at all. I would say if for us to get off to a good start, I think, you know, conquering all of this Han territory would have been what Liu Bei has conquered would have been us getting off to a good start. But it is not the case. And this settlement over here is not going to be easy to get through. Just move to the edge here. Especially if there's an army over there. If there's an army over there, we might as well just fucking wave the white flag. There's an army sitting in the settlement. I really wanted to take that back. But we can't afford, obviously, to fight a war on two fronts. I can't believe he declared war on us. Same shit that happened. Offered us non-aggression, and then a few turns later, declared war on him. I guess that's the lesson is, oh shoot, the faction leader died. That is the lesson. So, alliance war. At war with Cao Cao. So we're at war with... Oh my god. Look at all the factions we're at war with now. Alliance war. At war. Well... A level 5 settlement, can we take it? That's the question. Alright, let's, I feel like the trade influence is kind of a waste. How do you get these ones? Oh, you need, requires a certain building to be built. This is not going to have an immediate effect. 15% income from industry. The available army that might come in handy soon. So I think, we can get our income up a little bit. Actually, let's, use our... Oh, fuck. Huang Xiao is in there. Though if we can draw him out... Ooh, man, that's tough. That's tough. Saber cavalry compared to our mounted saber. Man, I don't know. That's tough. Because most of the battles that we've been able to fighting these guys is going to be a hell of a lot different than fighting the yellow turbans. You know what? We need to draw him over to here to attack the settlement. And in a defensive battle, we can defeat him. Or if he gets drawn out by Gongsun Zan. That was Gongsun Zan that was right there. But, yeah. We need to pull him into a battle where we're fighting him in a defensive situation. Or if we can attack the settlement, the city, when he's not there. He's just sitting put, staying put. Oh man, this is a really awkward campaign we've got going. Real, I was hoping for a overpowered Kong Rong campaign, but that has not been the case at all. Are we still fucking replenishing? Holy shit. Not a lot of archers, though. A lot of archers in there. I wish we could see the, settlement. Level 6, large city. man. It's just, I don't know. We haven't assaulted anything to this scale, and we've only got one trebuchet. I'm just thinking that, yeah, it's not an ideal situation, because we're not going to have a lot of movement. Well, what I'm thinking here is we do multiple assaults on the city, with our archers, because we've got them. Is this guy, are we at war with this guy? Liu Dei? Alliance war. Does that mean we're at war with him? I don't think we can attack him there. Where is he going? What I'd like to do is draw him out of there and fight him here at Kong Rong. But yeah, assaulting, doing multiple assaults could potentially work. But the problem is, if we move in, we're not going to have a lot of movement. We don't have enough movement. I wonder how much movement does he have. He's got quite a bit of movement there. Yeah, and I'm just wondering, do the level 6 settlements have artillery pieces? It's a big city. Though that would be a huge victory if we could get it. Let's try one turn. Let's see if we can draw him out first. And if he doesn't come out, then we're gonna try this assault. We can move forward a little bit, but alright, he is coming out. Ambush succeeded. Got them outnumbered, but just the quality. He's got the cav advantage on us. And every battle that we've fought against the yellow turbans, we had the we had the cavalry advantage. Are you shitting me? Oh, we can retreat again. That's weird. Ah, bollocks, he went back. Ah, all right, have another idea. Oh, got an ambusher over here. The little conqueror, Kong. Sun Si, the son of the late Sun Jian, has become famed throughout the land for his exploits in conquering the Southlands. The people have come to call him the little conqueror, and you hear it spoken throughout your capital. Increased recruitment. 10 replenishment faction wide. Where was that ages ago? There's an army. There's a dude sitting right there. Let's put you in the settlement. And you. We've got to address this ambush failed. Okay. Alright. Good. Lucky. Lucky that, they've got a trebuchet. They have got a trebuchet. Only 1,500 of them. No, we're not getting our reinforcements, though. Yeah, let's do it. Ah. Yuan Shao, I did not want to go to war with Yuan Shao. Frustrating. Frustrating turn of events. What do they got for Cav? This guy a Cav? Can't tell. Try and get through this without too much damage because we do have Yuan Shao on our doorstep potentially. But yeah. To get really creative to draw him out. Go back a little bit. Actually, I don't want it quite. Kong in behind as usual. He's on guard mode. On guard mode as well. We don't see them. The thing we gotta worry about is their artillery piece. Which I might try and sneak through the forest here. Get to the back. Are they moving forward? Can't see them now. Looked like they were moving forward though. I'm gonna keep you guys hidden. And forward slowly, but our cav is not that much bigger than theirs. It's a dangerous unit there. You guys back up a little bit. Move up. Where are they going? Do they know our cav is here? We're all hidden. Almost in range of that blob. Oh, come on. Yeah, I want to get to their artillery piece, but it just might not be worth it. Well, we might be able to get back there now. Go around a long way here. Sneak in behind. Because I have a feeling come on, get some shots off. They're gonna turn everybody around as soon as we charge into their artillery.
Alright,
shut it down. I got some horse archer or regular archers. Yeah, they have turned around a little bit. Oh, why? Fuck. Shoot it. Shoot at that. Alright, we'll take out the artillery piece and then get out of here. Or actually, we're gonna have to fight these dudes. Fuck, I don't want to fight these G. Alright. pull away. Fuck, I don't know. I don't know if it was worth it. We're gonna suffer some casualties here withdrawing. But they should come to us now. Yeah, let's just get out of there. And hopefully not have to use our cavalry too much. Let's come up and take this ridge. Oh. Should be able to take them on. And so far so good here. You, who are you shooting? You shoot at him. Or actually those crossbows is a good target. These guys are almost down. Yeah, we are taking some damage on our cav.
Pull
out. Wanna get out of range of their range units. Yeah, I don't like the damage we're taking on the cav. This dude is gonna be deadly. Shots in on him. Fuck. Gonna have a major cav fight on our hands here. Send a spear over there to help out. Think out those dudes. Think out those crossbows. Where are my spears? Come on, get in there. Alright, don't get drawn into those G infantry. And you just hold up. God damn it. We get those crossbows shut down. Need you to shut down those crossbows. Now the worst thing about this is that it's gonna take us a few turns to replenish after this, but we should get a little bit of loot from this, which we kind of really desperately need. Maybe we can start building up our provinces a little bit more. And yeah, building up our provinces a little bit more and maybe getting enough money that we can actually afford I thought this battle was over. Afford a few more troops, because that's what we're gonna need to take on Yuan Shao. But yeah, that's. So we'll take this as a blessing for now, depending on how much money we get from it. Try and goad Yuan Shao into attacking us, but if he doesn't, maybe we can, in a few turns, afford a few more troops, and make the assault on that settlement, that level 6 city. I mean, if there was no army sitting inside there, no problem. We'd be able to take it. I mean, it still might be a little bit tricky, because a level 6 settlement is no joke. But, but with an army in there, it's just a whole totally different thing. Not to be trifled with. Not too bad damage there, but damage on the cav. But yeah, this is a big coalition that's against us. Fucking Yuan Shao. At least when Gongsu Zan declared war on us, it was just him. He didn't drag a bunch of other factions in. We only lost 229. That's actually not too bad at all. Felt like we're losing more. We could employ him. But let's release him for 200 gold. And let's ransom for 604. Alright, what do we got? What do we have? Increase the speed of the retinue. Ooh, more resolve, more armor. I think we'll go with the more resolve. Increases, what's his retinue size now? Say? Age 41. Plus 33%. Let's go champion. 10% armor. And a little bit of bigger retinue. Resolve. 100 out of 2. Plus 40% general's bodyguard size. I wonder what the initial is. Come up and stand there. Going to encamp. Ah, bollocks. Can this guy... Ooh. Yeah, no, it's a bad idea. Bad idea. I was going to send this guy to attack them on his own. But, not a great idea, in my opinion. Alright, what can we do to increase our, got just enough for this. What does this do? That would give us 20 more income. This would give us another 20 income. And this is the same 20 income. And this is 1900, which would give us another 20 income. So the economy is not exactly going to get rolling here with this stuff. But let's build this in the heart. 4 turns as well. God. I don't know if that's worth it or not. Yeah, I'd be interested to see if Yuan Shao comes out now. But yeah, it's too bad we didn't have enough movement to finish this guy off, because he's probably going to run away and escape now. It would have been nice to get a little bit more experience. Oh, is he... Oh, stay put. Friendship is forming. Can friendship bloom on the battlefield? It would appear so, as two comrades find comfort in one another, laughing, training, and dining together. Their bond is emblematic of the strength that will reunify China. God. We're so poor. Oh my gosh. Surprising that he didn't move out of there. Does this give, no, it doesn't give any, Yeah, it doesn't give any bonus like Warhammer where you get melee defense bonus. We really should delegate this, but I don't want to take any casualties here. So let's fight it. Fight one more battle and then call it a day. It's been a little bit of a frustrating stream. Of course it's going to be forested territory. I guess we are fighting them and attacking them where in the forest where we are on the campaign map. Should have taken a look at the map first. But yeah, it's been a little bit of a frustrating day. We are in a tight situation with our new enemy, Yuan Shao. He's definitely going to, I don't want you guys in the fighting, if we can avoid it. You two, if you're needed, we'll call on you. But yeah, we might be able to root Yuan Shao over there, out of there. Probably another artillery piece might be useful. Though, see, the nice thing about the archers, why I spam a lot of archers, is because they're super cheap. And like early on, you just really need to get the numbers up. God, I love. This is one of the things I really love about this game is how the campaign map and how closely tied the campaign map is to the, I want to change this to Firewall. To the battle map. The battle maps are really reflected really well. Like, the campaign map is reflected really well on the battle maps. That it's tied in really... really well, whereas like a game like Warhammer, it's kind of it's not necessarily the case. The maps are, you know, you've got a lot of maps that match the terrain type, but they don't actually match the specific terrain to the area necessarily. If that makes any sense. Stretch out a little bit more. Archers. Going to shield wall, protect from that archer fire. Yeah, our switch these guys to flaming shot just because I wanted to catch some of the trees and stuff on fire, but it's just too inaccurate to hit these individual units, and especially these depleted units. Into there. We might send you guys up. For fuck's sake. Love the music for Three Kingdoms. It's another thing I love about this game. Some really good tunes. Just wish there was like a little bit more, like a little bit more diversity. Never have too much. You can never have too many songs for a Total War game. Because I mean, you're putting in so many hours every campaign. I mean, look at this. We're 5 hours in, and we barely scratched the surface of the campaign. I was hoping we could kind of catch these guys, but I don't think it's going to be the case. Ooh. Just this guy might take a little bit of time to replenish, but the rest of them were in pretty decent shape. We only lost 4 there, so that's good. At least for the money again, and we'll ransom for the money again. We're desperate. Desperate for the cash. Desperate for the cash. So, good start. So, we'll, we're gonna leave it here. I'm gonna have to figure out something pretty creative to get it into Dong. That is going to be a tough nut to crack. No pun intended. It's gonna be a really tricky situation. But what I'm thinking, what we could do is we could put Kong in camp stance here, and put the other army in ambush stance behind him so that he thinks it's a weaker force than it is. That might draw him out, but in camp stance will give us a better chance, but still it might be a little bit too much for us. I don't know. The ideal situation would be for us to draw him out and have him fight us at Dong Ping Ling. Fight here in a defensive situation, or if we could catch him out of his settlement, if he goes out and moves out. But yeah, we're kind of we're in a tight spot here with him. But you know, at the same time, if we can capture this settlement, we could use it as a choke point, and we could potentially declare war on Gongsunzan and go north. Which was what I wanted to do. Fuck. Would have been so much easier to fight him, because we've got minor settlements, small settlements, and he doesn't have an alliance. But anyway, I am definitely rambling on, guys. Just thinking out loud, trying to figure out how we're going to get out of this sluggish, pathetic start of the campaign. But I digress. Have a great day, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for your support. And I will see you in the next time, next one. Ragnarok signing out.